Wala pa yung angkal.
Delegated function na binigay ng batas ng Pilipinas sa mga local executive na hindi pwedeng i-delegate kanino man. Hindi pwedeng secretary ni mayor, hindi pwedeng konsehal. Dalawa lang po ang pwedeng magkasal sa munisipyo, si mayor lang o local chief executive at ang municipal trial court judge lang. So, ang pagkakasal po ng civil wedding ngayon ay napaka-ikit. Ang daming requirements na hinihingi no, sa baba. Sa akin ang process dito. Ang daming mga original BSA documents. In fact, nag-seminar pa kayo at naghintay ng araw bago po kayo ganap na pwede ng kasalin. So, itong seremonya po ngayon ay isang, kumaga, icing of the cake lang. Kumaga, halos talagang nasensyado na sila at pwede na talaga ikasal. Dito po sa bayan ng Manawag, nandiyan si Apo Kapitan ng Milona ng Pamasit. Nakapasit si Giselle, ay karamihan po ng mga weddings, lalo na sa ating mga Katoliko, ay nangyayari po sa Basilica. Since we are a pilgrimage town, no, most of the marriages happens in the church. Yan po ay tinatawag na religious solemnization ng marriage. So, mas dito po ay civil wedding. Huwag niyong kakalimutan na si Lord pa rin na nagpahintulot at gumawa ng time na ito at binigay sa inyo bilang araw ng inyong kasal. kaya ng dragon. Sa church wedding po, meron isang ginagawa dyan, yung marriage bonds na tinatawag. Hindi ko man o, yung ikakasal ay inubuha ko at binabanggit ang kanilang mga pangalan ng tatlong linggo doon sa simisa ng alas 7 ng umaga. Now, just to ascertain na wala mong problema o walang sakit ang ikakasal. Paano yan gagawin sa civil wedding tulad ito? 7 years, imagine. Ako po kasi very particular din pa ako sa time ng pinagsama ng ikakasal. Bakit? Dahil marami kang madidiscover sa panahon eh. Nadadaan. Unang-una yung ugali. Unang-una yung mga moods niya, no? So, ibig sabihin, with that 11 years, that is no joke. Kilala niya na bawat isa. Tama? Anong tawag niya naman? Anong hindi yung address niya? Midi. Hindi naman Midi. Midi kasi, ano ba? Midi. Si Mi at saka si D. Okay, and finally, now that you have reached this point, ito na lang po ang kulang for that 11 years. Yung nakalalabas na yung baby mo at sa gusto ko dyan, mukhang babae. Ay, lalaki ba? Naku, lalaki na talaga. Kasi pag lalaki po sa ultrasound, siguradong lalaki na. Pag babae, minsan, nagbago pa, no? And by the way, ako po yung doktor din po by profession, anesthesiologist po ako. At yun, kami nag-cater ng painless delivery o kaya yung cesarean. So kung walang anesthesiologist, walang operasyon na nangyayari. Okay, so anong masasabi ni Big kay Me ngayon? Na finally, after 11 years, na few message coming from your very heart. Instant, impromptu, anong masasabi mo ngayon kay Me, kay Giselle? Now that, ito na hinihintay ng lahat, no? No, walang hiya ka na.
Iiyak na yan.
Is no bed of roses. Hindi ibig sabihin na masaya lahat. In fact, with that 11 years, ang dami ng pagsubok na dinaanan niya, definitely. Sa hirap at ginhawa, marami ng away, maraming tampuhan, maraming issues. So, ganun po ang realidad ng buhay mag-asawa. It's no bed of roses. Maraming frustrations, maraming failures as you go on in married life. Pero sa buhay, ang sumuko ay talo. Kaya dapat walang susuko. Wala rin perfectong couple, wala rin perfectong mag-asawa. marami rin mga kakulangan. So, importante, kung walang perfectong couple, dapat may perfectong team. At yun dapat starting today. You work as a team, support each other with respect. No? Nandyan parati yung respeto. Kaya keep on saying it, pray together. Dahil lahat naman, naka-depende naman tayo lahat sa buhay kay Lord. Kaya nga, put God always in the center of your relationship. We pray together. Paglabas ng baby nyo, si baby boy, we pray as a family. Because the family that prays together stays together. Totoo po yan. So, totoo nga, dapat simula, dapat nangyari na nun, pero officially today, you should serve as the number one cheerleader ng bawat isa. Suportahan mo dapat yung gustong gawin ng asawa mo. Hindi ka dapat number one critic. Marami pong mag-asawa, number one critic yung kanilang asawa. May iniisip pa lang na gawin si Mr. o si Mrs. kumukontra na isa. No? At isang good, hindi yan dapat. Dapat suportahan mo yung asawa mo. No? So, starting today, you dream as a couple. Yung wala yung kanya-kanya pangarap. Dream together. No? At mangangarap na rin, libre naman itong mangarap, laki-lakihan na natin yung pangarap natin. So dream as a couple, no, for the fun. Dapat may plano. Kung baka parang nag-drive ng sasakyan, ngayon sumakay ka ng kotseng ang tawag ay mag-asawa. Dapat may direction, may gusto kayong gawin sa buhay. May target, mag-plano in short. No? So after God, time is important. No? Pareha pa kayong babalik ng Taiwan. Hindi. Sana lang, no? Kaso magiging LDR, no? So, with the advances in technology ngayon, virtually imposible na hindi mo makakausap minuman sa buong mundo in real time pa, naka-video pa dahil na internet. So, ibig sabihin, kung gusto, may paraan. Pag ayaw, maraming dahilan. Yung mga dahilan na low bat, dead bat, o kaya walang signal, panis na yun. Huwag kang maniwala dahil nga kung gusto mo talaga, dahil critical ang communication. No? Dapat nag-uusap. Dapat every time na may chance nag-uusap, check on each other, kumusta ka, kumain ka na, aligo ka na, mga ganong bagay. So little things are the big things in married life. Okay, so maliban sa time, aminin na natin na pinag-aawayan ng mag-asawa para ito pera. So you should be the master of your money and not the other way around. No? Dapat common fund na yan starting today. Wala po yung pera ni Frank o ni Nature at iba yung pera ni Giselle. Ngayon, simula ngayon, dapat pera nyo together. So, this money, your money should work for you and not the other way around. Okay? So, tatanungin ko po ngayon si Nature, Frank. Budget ba ito? Bahit. Kasi pag budget, ito. Bahit. Segundo, do you take your bride here present named Giselle Cariño Calusa to be your lawful wife, to raise a family with her, to be sensitive to her needs, and to live with her for the rest of your life?
Yes, ma'am.
And for Giselle Cariño Calusa, do you take your groom here present named Melchor Park, bahit, segundo, to be your lawful husband, to raise a family with him, to be sensitive to his needs, and to live with him for the rest of your life?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so again, sabi ko in marriage, the little things are the big things. Acts of service, yung pagsisilbihan ng mga acts, love languages ng bawat isa, dapat alam nyo na. Yung weakness ni Giselle, anumang ginagawa mo, tayo in love siya lalo. In short, what made you reach this point, other than God, after God, of course, is the love that you have been nurturing for the 11 years. Nothing will change after today, walang mababago. In short, you should, mas maganda nga, encourage to keep the fire burning, the treatment of lovers as boyfriend, girlfriend should continue despite having these legal documents of being husband and wife officially. No? In short, the love that made you bonded together should always be there. No, yung love, no? Love is always the answer, no? Pag may issue na kayo. No, example, may kaaway, never go to bed with issues hanging. Dapat nag-uusap. And somebody has to sacrifice. And getting married also entails sacrifice. Hindi yan puro ikaw ang bidawan, but dapat minsan nagigib in the next sacrifice for the sake of the family, no? So example, naiingay si Giselle, nagalit na galit. Hindi ko natin sasabay ka at mag-iingay ka rin, di ba? Dapat somebody has to be silent. Hindi matatapos ang never lie in bed, never go to bed with issues namin na pag-uusapan lahat ng bagay, no? Maraming nag-away, hindi lang pala nag-usap. Pero pag pinag-usap, oo nga pala, no? Nagre-reconcile. It's the communication gap. There should be, and there should never be communication gap between both of you. Nag-uusap kayo parati. Okay? So, i-request the ninong-ninang to please stand up, yung ating mga ninong-ninang po. In behalf of the couple, marami pong salamat for accepting the sort of responsibility to stand as their second parents in their union as husband and wife. Sabi ko po sa kanila, God first. Kaya dito po sa aming bayan, ganito po yung sign namin. Una si Lord, God first, then second, ay kayong dalawa. No, who will make this union successful? After God will be both of you. Ulit-ulit, support each other, magtulungan. No? Never, parating ko sasabi rin, do never treat each other as siblings. Marami pong kinasal. After nagkasal nila mismo, nagbabago na. Parang hindi na sila lovers. Parang ordinary magkasama. May naririnig pa natin, kasi na kami man doon nagkabsat, kunadaya. I strongly disagree. Dahil nga po dapat, ang layo naman kasi ang diferensya ng asawa sa magkapatid. So, dapat yung sweetness mo hindi mababago, yung treatment mo as we lovers for the 11 years should continue, no? So, yung love language sometimes kasama po dyan ang physical touch, kasama dyan ang pagbigay ng gift, no? Or pagsisilbihan mo ang bawat isa. Yun yung mga maliit na bagay na akala natin maliit nga, pero in the long run, sila po yung mga malalaki na nagbibigay tibay doon sa pagsasama ng mga asawa. Okay? So we shall now come to the ring ceremony. Ang sing-sing po ay walang dugtong. Dahil it symbolizes infiniteness. Same goes as you perceive your union today as infinite until death. Do you guys part each other? So there for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer until death. Kaya nga dito sa ating bansa, bawal ang divorce, illegal. Kaya nga ang paniniwala namin lahat, especially to your parents and your godparents na magsasama kayo habang buhay. Okay? So sabi ko nga, kung may mahalagang desisyon ng tao, ito po yung isa. Ang desisyon na gusto mo ng mag-asawa. And with that 11 years, it's no joke, mahabang panahon na po yan para makita yung ayaw mo at ma-appreciate yung mga gusto mo at matanggap kung ano yung pagkukulang ng bawat isa. Diba? At ito na yun, kaya tayo nandito ngayon. Okay? Wala natin may in front. Taba mo na.
Let's pray.
Ito ay, yung suit naman.
Your misery.
In your finger.
As a sign.
My love.
Loyalty.
I'm fidelity.
To you today.
And for us now.
As I do.
Okay, so susunod na yung ring, then kiss the ring. Kiss the ring. Palakpakan mo natin si Melton Park.
Where is my love?
Aris is a symbol of God's abundant provision to your household. Ito na yung sasabi ko, pera has always been an issue to a lot of problems. Sana hindi maging issue sa inyo. Bottom line, it should be transparent. No? Dapat pera nyo, hindi pera ng bawat isa. So in principle, with this ceremony, all the monetary blessings that comes your way, Melcher, should be remitted to Giselle. And in your household, Giselle will serve as the, not just the boss or the manager of your household. She will also serve as the treasurer. Siya ang kaingat yaman ng pamilya, yung pera ng pamilya. No? And she will also serve as the auditor. Kaya nga siya lahat. No? Tatangon na lang tayong mga lalaki. No? But anyway, kidding aside, what if Metro did something to buy? Hindi automatic na bilhin mo kagad bago sabihin. Remit mo muna. Dahil pang nasinan, si Baba kami nag-remit na purlata ng nakapa. Kato, treat money carefully. Okay? Marami pong nag-away sa pera ng magkasama. Okay, so they make money work for you and you should serve as the master of your money. I'm not the other way around. Okay?
I receive this.
The ultimate orchestrator of all things that be, we come before you in unison with Melchor Frank and Giselle in their desire to be united in marriage. We ask that you bless their marriage as they remain faithful in obeying your word. Surround them with godly mentors who will generously give them godly counsel and guide them in the path of righteousness. Holy Spirit, develop in them conviction on faithfulness, trust on righteousness. Inculcate in them commitment to your word, commitment to their vows, and commitment to each other. Bless the works of their hands and the fruits of their marriage. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Maraming salamat. And for the pronouncement, wherefore, parties having made their commitment to each other, I, Mayor Jeremy Aherico Rosario, by the power vested on me by law, as the local chief executive of our beloved town, Manawa, I now pronounce Melchor Frank and Giselle as husband and wife. Congratulations. Okay, Melchor, you may now execute 11, paano to 11 years? Kaka naman. 11 minutes, takal na na. 11 seconds, ako magbibilang. You may now execute your first legal kiss to your lovely wife, Giselle. Eleven seconds of pagbibilang. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mabuhay ang bagong kasal! So, andyan na po nagtatapos. Maraming salamat po sa ating mga kaibigan from San Nicolas and of course from Malawag. So, on behalf of LGU Malawag, Mayor Dr. Ng, congratulations ulit and God bless. Thank you po. Yes.
Isa lamang po dapat ang ilaw ng tahanan, sapagkat ang maraming ilaw, mahal na ang babayaran sa kuryente. Sir Melchor, subuan mo na ang iyong thesis. Ma'am Giselle, subuan mo na ang iyong mister. Palakpakan naman. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sir,
may ilang mesa po kayo dyan, sir.
Okay,
yung mga wala ka pong mga upuan, please, magandang na lamang po kayo ng upuan para po kakain na po tayo. And 5. Ayan! Palakpakan naman po natin ang ating newly wed. Para...
Maraming salamat po sa mga lahat ng dumating sa araw na kasama namin.